All right. Well, look, we've got Andy Kroll, one of my favorites, always there with a great story. Today, what we've got, though, is he's talking about the money in the presidential elections. Unlike previous presidential elections, this year's election isn't only about the candidate. It's about who can build the biggest war chest. This year, it's all about which candidate has the most super PACs pouring money into advertising on their behalf. Andy Kroll, Mother Jones, smart guy, really great writer. Andy, let me ask you something. We all knew the money was coming. Did we know it was going to come in a tsunami?
No one knew that we were going to see Republican and conservative groups on the outside, not the candidates, the outside folks, plan to raise up more than $1 billion to beat Obama and to take full control of the Congress. I mean, this money is unprecedented. We've never seen anything like it. You know, and we wouldn't be in this situation if we didn't have super PACs, if we didn't have, you know, the likes of Karl Rove and the Koch brothers using all these nonprofit groups and this dark money to just dump money into elections all around the country, you know, from the White House on down the ticket.
Well, one thing we know is Karl Rove, he fought like a crazy man to get crazy people appointed to the Supreme Court. I mean, you know, he was the Alito guy. He was the Roberts guy. He was the Clarence Thomas guy. I mean, he was the person who pushed these judicial hacks. That's what they are in the U.S. Supreme Court. Scalia is a judicial hack. He's a cartoon character. We didn't used to have a Supreme Court like that, but that's what he pushed. But now we're finding he's even going beyond what they told him he could do, because Karl Rove is now violating so much of what U.S. is, what from what Citizens United said. He's actually determining what the message is after he confers with Mitt Romney's camp about what the message should be. And then he's putting that money into super PACs. And, yeah, it's not – they're not mentioning Mitt Romney, but it is the Mitt Romney folks that are driving the train about what's being said.
It's not hard for folks on the Republican side to figure out what their strategy is going to be and what their message is going to be. You know, and frankly, they don't even need to be backroom conversations and secret meetings. You know, Karl Rove is on Fox News all the time. Romney campaign people are on Fox News all the time. Karl Rove has a column in the Wall Street Journal. Romney aides and surrogates write in the Wall Street Journal. You know, it's happening in the light of day. It's
the
right
Chinese wall is important,
Andy.
The Chinese wall is impossible. Is what you're saying? Is what I'm saying? There's no Chinese wall here. The $94 million dollars that, you know, $355 million that comes into the Romney camp by way of super PACs is being channeled by the Mitt Romney folks. There's no question about that. It's not supposed to be, but it is.
Yeah, I mean, the donors who are pumping money into Mitt Romney's campaign are the same kinds of donors who are giving to his super PAC. We have established that. You know, there was a recent analysis that 1 in 10 big Romney donors has given to the super PAC, and so there's crossover there. It's all, I mean, you got to think when a fundraiser for Romney's super PAC or for his campaign walks into a room, they don't have to make a pitch. All they have to say is Barack Obama or Obamacare, and the checks come out and the money is raised. And it was like that for Democratic fundraisers when George W. Bush was in office. And so it doesn't take much to raise a huge amount of money. I mean, the difference in 2010, 2011, 2012 is that there are so many new ways for unlimited money to be pumped into the system than there were before.
Well, yeah, there's another part of this story. The other part is that the Adelson types, the Boston financier, John Childs types, Bob Perry, developer, home builder type out of Texas, you know, the big money, their name is out there already. But you have people like Hewlett Packard. You know, this is a guy, the CEO of Hewlett Packard, who's putting huge money into these super PACs. He doesn't want people to know that because people might not buy his product. For example, we won't buy his product here in a very large law firm now that we know this. You know, just like the Dell story. When people react to buying products, when you got somebody who's in the business of selling Hewlett-Packard and you find out, what do you stand for? Well, I've put all this money into a Mitt Romney character who is barely American. You know, he may as well be a foreigner. He's got all his money off-site. He may as well not even be here. Or the guy, the CEO of the company Skull Candy, Jeremy Andrus. I mean, once we know who they are, we react to that. So they're trying to keep it secret. Not only are they giving this huge money, they're skulking around, you know, like hyenas in the dark. Trying to say, don't let anybody know that Hewlett Packard gave the money or Skull Candy gave the money to somebody who's just absolutely disgusting. Don't let anybody know that. That's the other part of this story, isn't it?
Yeah, and that's why you don't see, you know, big corporations like Goldman Sachs or Dow Chemical or Target or Home Depot or a big recognizable brand giving big chunks of money to these super PACs. They don't do that because they know there's blowback. And for them, you know, they have to keep in mind their shareholders and what's good for the company. And they know that if they give money to a super PAC supporting Romney, that there's going to be a lot of blowback. And that's where you start to, we don't know for certain, but you start to think, okay, well, maybe then the you know, large corporations that have a brand to protect, maybe they're giving to these nonprofits. Maybe they're giving to the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, which does not disclose its donors.
Right, exactly.
And they're having an impact that way, but they're not having their name out there. And, you know, for instance, we know that Aetna, the health insurance company, you know, by essentially a clerical mistake, we found out that they had given several million dollars to a conservative nonprofit group that doesn't disclose its donors, but Aetna screwed up and did anyway. There was blowback for them, and people don't want that exposure, and that's where these dark money groups become so useful.
But we're finding an interesting thing, Andy, that's developing, is you have a whole industry that's developing around this election of people who are finding out. I mean, you can't hide it totally. People who understand how the system works, it's like, you know, we've got five people at this law firm, for example. They're not lawyers. What they are is they're accountants. They're people who understand how to go forensic accountants. They understand where the money is, where it goes. You have people like that developing throughout the country that are letting the stories getting out that, yeah, Hewlett-Packard is putting in all the CEO of Hewlett-Packard putting all this money into this campaign. Skull Candy, you know, they put money in. Well, there's other things you can buy. You know, you don't have to buy Skull Candy. There's plenty of other things you can buy to do the same thing. So I think people, you know, they better hide. They better hide because we see what happens when people get pretty angry about it. They do something about it, don't they?
Oh, yeah, exactly. I mean, the case study here is Target a couple of years ago gave some money to a group in Minnesota that it thought was working on, like, economic whatever issues. What ended up happening was this group came out as anti-same-sex marriage. And, you know, Target likes to cast itself as hip and with it and, you know, appealing to younger crowds. And, you know, younger people are much more in favor of same-sex marriage. That blew up on their face. They got picketed. People mm-hmm. said they weren't going to buy their products anymore. Shareholders got pissed off. Corporations do not want that. I mean, I hear the name Target all the time in this context. We don't want to end up like Target. And while you're right, there are a lot of folks who are tuning in and digging up these donations as much as possible, probably with the of them.
We are, Andy, and I know you are all the time. We're out of time.
Trying.
Yeah, we're trying. We're doing it every day, and you're doing a hell of a job. Keep it up.